Hi YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony, and I'm going to show you how I make popcorn balls. I'm actually making multiple batches tonight because my daughter's taking them in for a birthday treat tomorrow. So, let's just get started. Kitchen's in a bit of disarray right now because I'm trying to do 40,000 things at once. But the first thing you're going to do is pop up some popcorn, and you're going to want about 15 cups. Now I'm using an older recipe, and it says 12 cups, but over the years I've found that 15 cups works a little better. And when I see a cup of popcorn, oops, there's something on. That's what I would call a cup of popcorn. So I'm going to measure out 15 cups into this bowl from this one, and I'll come back. This is the recipe I'm using, Pillsbury Kitchen's Family Cookbook. This thing is about 30 years old. I had it before I was married. I've been married 26 years, and I use a lot of recipes out of this book, but over the years I've tweaked them. And this one, you'll see my little notes. This is the problem with this cookbook. It's got my little notes all over it. But this is the recipe. If you come across this book, pick it up. It's a wonderful recipe book, especially if you're a beginning cook. If you've just gotten married and you didn't get to cook much growing up, pick this one up. It's wonderful. Probably on eBay or something. Anyway, so this is the recipe. So we're going to mix the, I don't know if you call it the topping or whatever, the syrup, I guess you'd call it, for the popcorn balls. Okay, in my saucepan here, I have a stick of butter, 1 cup of sugar, 2/3 cup of corn syrup, 2/3 cup of water, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of vinegar, and I'm going to double check my recipe, make sure I'm not forgetting anything. Nope, that's pretty much it. Now this time I happen to use apple cider vinegar. You can use regular vinegar, apple cider vinegar, doesn't make any difference, whatever you have on hand. And I'm going to cook this now on a relatively high burner. If you can see that, I don't want to zoom in, but anyway, to 300 degrees, and that's a hard crack stage. Now my recipe says to cook it to 270, which they call it the soft crack stage. You don't want to do that because that's going to make your popcorn balls really sticky and difficult to eat. It's going to pull out your fillings, if not your teeth. And that's the problem with a lot of popcorn balls, is that they're too sticky, they're too tacky. So go ahead and cook this to just under 300 degrees or 300 degrees, and it's going to make it almost like caramel corn. It's going to turn a little brown, but that makes it so easy to eat. They're very crunchy, and they break away when you bite into them, and you don't get all this stickiness. And that takes a little bit. You stir it once in a while. You don't have to sit here and stir it constantly, but just keep it from sticking out of the bottom. Use a really good pan. This one happens to be copper bottom. And, you know, just let it cook. Don't turn your burner up too high that it cooks too fast. You do want it to cook for a little bit, like 10-15 minutes. And well, we'll come back when it gets to that point, and we'll pour it on our popcorn, and that gets to a little bit of the tricky part. It's forming the balls with a very hot popcorn with a very hot syrup on it anyway, but we'll come back to that. While that's cooking, we're about at the 200, just under 250 degree stage. I just want to mention something. Before we get to the part where we're actually forming the balls, I strongly recommend that you get yourself some rubber gloves. not that it's sticky, but the recipe recommends using buttered hands. Well, you're going to burn the crap out of your hands. In fact, even using these, it takes away a little bit of the burn, but you're still going to have to work quick and give yourself a break in between, you know, rolling each ball so that you don't burn your hands. This is the hard part of making popcorn balls. If you let it cool too much, you aren't going to be able to form the balls because it's going to set up before you get them molded. So get some of these. You don't need to butter them. I used to butter them, but you don't need to do that. And that helps cut down on the pain a little bit. Remember, this is a labor of love, and they are so good. It's worth it. I don't know if you can see this, but when it starts to turn a golden color, maybe even a light tan golden brown, I really start stirring it, and I keep stirring it until it reaches that 300 mark. And that usually happens when it gets very close to it, so this is when I really start stirring. Now, when it gets to 300, you remove it from the stove and add your vanilla. Okay, and stir that in. I'm going to get rid of my thermometer. I no longer need it. And I'm going to put you down a minute and stir it up. Okay, I've got you on a stand. I hope you can see this. Look at this beautiful brown caramel. Okay, got my gloves on. I'm going to pour it over the popcorn, mixing it in as best I can. I have to work quickly because this stuff, because we're heating it to a higher temperature, it's going to set up relatively fast. And then the painful part starts. You have to tell yourself it's a labor of love. I have made popcorn balls for my girls' birthday every day, or every year since they started school. And now the kids know that my girls bring popcorn balls on their birthday, and they expect it. So I can't disappoint them. Even when I don't have time, it's after midnight, actually. That's when I do most of my cooking, actually, or baking, and stuff like this. Unless I have the girls want to do it with me. Okay, we got it all mixed in. I hope you can see this. I'm relying on my camera angle here. Now we're going to go in, and we have to go fast. I'm going to do this, and plop it on it. Grab some more. Try to get an equal number of, of caramel to popcorn. If you see some that aren't mixed in well, work it a little bit with your hands if you have to. Oh, man. It's good. Thing I'm filming, I won't make the air blue. And this gets you about, each batch, about a baker's dozen. 13. There's 30. Counting the teacher. I promise I won't make the air blue. Counting the teacher, there's about, I need 29 popcorn balls. So I'm making 3 batches. My husband will be thrilled. There will be some left over. Now my second batch, I didn't get it cooked as much as I like. I just noticed that. And it's a lighter color. And I'll show you the difference. This is about perfect. This is the color brown that you want your syrup to be. And if it's a little lighter, it's probably going to be a little chewier. This is perfect. Trying to get them the same size if you're making them for children. Do the best you can. Ow, dang. Love my kids, love my kids, love my kids. Oh, I hope I didn't get in the shot. I'm in my jammies, so I'm trying really hard not to be in this picture. In the bottom that I'm probably not going to make into a popcorn ball. Maybe for my husband. I don't think it's going to be enough for a full size one. Oh, maybe. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's going to be a real caramely one. Kind of small. Yeah, it's too small. Not a good one. My husband will eat it. All right. Grab my camera. So there is my mound of popcorn balls. Now, hoping you can see this. This is one of the ones I just made. Oop, extreme close-up. And I hope you can see the difference in brown. I'll probably have to shoot a still for you to see it. But this one is going to be chewier. And that's pretty much how the recipe tells you to make it. But this is the color you want for the ones that break apart really easy and don't take your teeth out. So I'll take a still of it. You can probably see it better. And I hope you try this recipe. Other than the painful part at the end, it's really not a hard recipe to follow. And the only problem is your family's going to want you to make it all the time. So be aware of that. One more note, how to clean up your pans. You can put some hot water in here, or you can put hot water in here and put it back on your stove if your hot water heater doesn't get hot enough, and that'll take that all off. You just basically dissolve it. I don't know if you can see these strands that when I was pouring it out. See how they just pop right off? That is what you want, because that's not going to take your teeth out. and it's a lovely caramel. You know, if you didn't want to make these into balls, you could just leave it in the bowl and break it up for caramel corn. It would be fine for that.